Hey guys, Dimal here, and today I am playing Call of Duty Black Ops 3.
Where am I?
I am. Okay. This is part 2 of the campaign. I'm finally back with it. It's been a month since I played this game. I'm gonna be quiet right now so you guys can listen to this.
It's always gonna be better than machine. Unfortunately, you sustained life threatening injuries. You're stable. You got a long way to go.
Who are you?
It's me, Taylor. I think it's time you woke up, don't you?
Yeah, so in the last video, my arms got ripped off by some robots. If you haven't seen the last video, go check it out. I'm finally getting back to the campaign. It's been a while.
Hey! Still with us?
So I'm gonna try to finish this campaign.
Welcome back.
Taylor.
Yeah.
Got some robot arms now. Or something like that.
Well, let's say you are. Why not just go with it, right? After all, you can always wake up. December 12th, 2054, 7:30 a.m. We're on board a private commuter train headed to the Zurich headquarters of the Coalescence Corporation. Our cargo, prototype for the Winslow Cord Neural Network Initiative. At its core, specialized AI software that's capable of rewriting itself in order to interface with any other system in the world. State-of-the-art stuff back in the day. It'd go on to revolutionize a broad range of military and civilian applications. At least, it would have if the train had reached its destination.
So this is a dream?
At 7:31 a.m., a terrorist group detonated an explosive device on board this train. The incident sent back our robotics program several years. You're here to stop it.
This isn't real. It can't be. What is happening to me?
Right now, you're in a medically induced coma being prepped for surgery. You've got a new bit of hardware inside your head. It's called a direct neural interface, or DNI. I've got one too. That's how I'm able to communicate with you. Your DNI is what connects your mind with your new body and the larger world around you.
So you put something in my brain?
All of this is a simulation inside our minds. And you got a long way to go.
Teleporting to another dream, I guess. Looks like it. The Call of Duty Black Ops games are kind of weird, the campaigns. Or like kind of crazy.
RPG! 11:30 a.m. December 11th, 2054.
Just threw another explosion at me.
Security forces receive an anonymous tip giving them the location of a hideout the terrorists are using. Unfortunately, the ZSF underestimated the firepower these assholes were packing. They got caught with their pants down, and they took it hard. Outcome, train go boom. You remember Diaz?
I think so.
Gonna help get you up to speed on some of the cool new shit you can do.
Communication, brother. We all gotta be in sync.
Yo, Taylor, you're a fucking dick.
You didn't hear shit? If I want to talk to you, the DNI transmits on a closed channel. I don't even have to think about it. But, just so you know, if you ever think about calling Taylor a dick for real, brother, he's gonna mess you up worse than those robots.
Okay.
Right. Let's go see if you can do this without ending up a Swiss cheese like those poor bastards.
Okay, weapon hot. Check the floor.
I climb that.
Move back,
right.
There's never just one route. High, low, left, right. Different paths yield different advantages.
He's gone!
Okay, I am.
Your DNI can provide critical info to help you better read the battlefield. Switch into tactical mode.
Ouch, that hurts. That was close. How did I die? Okay, let's try that again.
Flanking right.
There's never just one route. High, low, left, right. Different
paths
yield different advantages.
Well, let's try not to die this time. That almost exploded in my face.
Your DNI can provide combat critical info that you better read the battlefield. Switch it to tactical mode.
Contact. Well, that's nice to know. Okay, ouch.
Hang on! Hold your spot! Let's light him up!
Move! You just set yourself on fire.
Alright, use your enhanced mobility. It may take a little getting used to, but your confidence will soon grow. Try it for yourself. I got a hunter that says you can do it.
Alright, how do you do that? Well, I can't do that.
Attack mode will highlight inbound threats such as rockets and grenades. You see flashing red, move.
Like, what are you doing there?
See the red yellow markers? They represent kill zones. Somewhere you want to be. Reinforcements at the truck.
Get in there. I'm almost dead, which is not a good thing.
One of us sees something, we all see it, even through cover.
I just go up to these people and punch them. Hello.
Check your ammo. Grab more if you need it. Keep moving up!
Okay, I need to resupply. Not what I want. Pass. Okay, I need hide. I think this is where I'm supposed to be.
D&I doesn't just help us communicate with each other. It allows us to interact with a variety of computer systems.
including pretty much all the basic drone units. Now, biped, sophisticated ground units, those are a whole lot trickier, brother. Those sons of bitches got a damn hive mind. You try to process and control all that, your brain is toast. But these fuckers are easy. Go ahead, hack in. Go see what's on the other side of this wall.
Wow, I get control of a robot? Oh, I remember these things are from, I saw one of these in Black Ops 2. Okay, let's go. People down.
There she is. Blow that generator so we can get inside.
Come on.
I'm afraid the EMP blast from the generator was fried your drum. Come on, let's go.
What, I can't control any of these? Oh wait, oh yeah, we exploded it. Forgot.
Fresh ammo whenever you see an ammo crate. Last thing you want is to be in a fight with no bullets.
My shotgun's ready. I love the Call of Duty games. I played all, like every single Call of Duty game made.
Suppressors. Second level. If you want to get creative, you can use remote hijack on those turrets.
Okay.
Nice going. I'll turn back on them and tear them up.
Wow, I gotta control this. That broke.
Shoot down those vats. Thought their turrets would protect them.
You guys are gonna die. Should I kill as many people as we can with this thing? How many people are left over there? Ouch.
Gotta get out of here! The faction's hideout is just ahead. Once inside, interface with the central console. Pull any data you can.
Okay, let's hack this thing. Using the power of the force. What the heck is this?
Hey, it's okay. It's okay.
I'm dreaming of what happened.
Take a deep breath in and tell me what happened.
That guy is scared of robots.
I was back in Ethiopia. The grunts, I lived it all again. What's happening to me?
Shit. You know how your senses can trigger vivid memories? Make you think of sounds, sights. Words from songs. Make you think of stuff you haven't thought of in years. D&I can make that a lot more visceral. Little glitches
what?
On your optics. Little whispers in your ear. Shit happens. The doctor can straighten it out. You just need to recalibrate your meds. Trust me. You're gonna be fine.
So what now?
Oh, right now? You're gonna interface with that console. As soon as you plug in, you'll be able to extract and process the information in a heartbeat.
Okay. Here's my robot hand.
They had a man on the inside. Had coalescence. He would have been able to supply them with everything they needed to bypass the security on the train.
botched assault, man. It took 6 hours for the ZSF to get that information. Outcome? Train go boom.
When did you get here, Taylor?
Yeah, it would have been 5. If you hadn't freaked out when you saw those robots.
So what happens now?
Now we go find the son of a bitch.
Okay. So far the campaign is going good, and it's awesome. I always say that. So that's the guy we have to capture?
Tipped off by his terrorist pals.
In another dream?
He had heavy-duty combat grunts with him. Once again, the Zerg security force got their asses handed to him. Outcome. Train go boom.
We lost him. He slipped away.
Who's that now?
Specialist Sarah Hall. She's gonna walk you through the next part. Trust her, do exactly what she says. I trained her myself. She's an intelligence expert from back when that actually meant something.
Before DNI, you had to read books. In the academy, Taylor made me read a lot of them.
Well, some knowledge is worth earning, appreciating, and that takes time. Time is something we don't always have.
Okay, new blood. From this point on, the simulation deviates from actual events. Not that it's gonna feel any less real. Use your imagination.
Let's do this. I'm gonna jump out a window. That robot was just standing there. Wait.
I'm starting to like you. I still have line of sight.
Oh, you're starting to like me? You should.
Bring it on! Our boy's hacking the ZSF talons. What does that tell you?
He's running scared. Not sitting behind a computer. He could only be controlling them if he's got a DNI too.
You're a smart one, new blood. I'll give you that. Son of a bitch is still moving.
Oops.
Use that billboard to get over the maglev train.
Excuse me, guys.
Zurich, move.
Any switch. Does that do anything? Yeah, that turns the drones off. Okay, I gotta run. I can.
Way to shut up your critics, new blood. Stay down. Don't lose him now, newbie.
Well, I can't run that fast. Come on.
Grab him, new blood. Now's your chance. Take him down.
Got him.
Didn't work out so well, huh? I reckon our suspect has about 15 seconds left before he shakes hands with the Grim Reaper. You can't let that happen. Not before you get the information we need.
I don't think he's in any condition to talk.
He doesn't have to. He has a DNI.
He does?
Buried beneath layers of security protocols, the subject's DNI records cam footage of the user's past experiences. In extreme circumstances, it is possible to extract that information by force. You'll be able to push deep into the subject's memories, their thoughts, even their subconscious. You could learn everything we need to know about the terrorist plans.
I'm sensing a butt coming up somewhere.
You should know. Not only will this procedure be deeply traumatic for the subject, but the associated subconscious interference will leave him brain dead. Dead. Believe me, this is a bad way to go.
He's a dead man anyway. Besides, he's a fucking terrorist.
Stealing his brain.
A few minutes ago, you knew nothing. What do you know now?
I know where they are. They're using the old train tunnel to plan their attack.
But you just learned through your DNI took the ZSF weeks to uncover. What do you think I'm gonna say next? Outcome. Train go boom.
You said that like 100 times already.
I think it's time we moved on.
Let's teleport to another dream. Okay, we're fighting robots now.
The ZSF finally tracked down the terrorists to this location. For their sake, they really wish they had.
You're still here, huh? Pity. I bet Diaz 100 that you'd be dead by now.
Funny man, Specialist Peter Moretti. He's gonna help you understand how much of a badass motherfucker you are now. But remember, we still don't have the last piece of the puzzle. How in the hell they got the explosives on board the train?
So we're clear? When this is over, you owe me 100. Back to business. As you know, one of the perks of being Black Ops is having access to the latest in experimental weaponry. Firearms may be your go-to choice for a weapon in a fight. But with D&I, your mind truly is your greatest weapon. Let's do some damage. Make a soldier out of you yet.
Take this way. One. How did I die? I didn't see anyone shooting me. That was not my fault. In here. What the heck? By the way, guys, I can't wait for Call of Duty Infinite Warfare to come out. Looks like an awesome game.
You ain't getting close.
Just need to wait for my health to get back up. Why did I pick the shotgun for this? Okay, I'm out of here. Damn, get in there. About your robot heart.
Not bad, new blood.
I'm just ripping robot hearts, or whatever robots have. Ooh. What are all these guys doing up here? Whoa. Okay, I'm out of there. I'm out. Wow, I almost died. Let's go for this gun. And hack this.
They're using smoke grenades.
Nice work. Switching to your EV helps whenever you're blind, whether in the dark or in smoke.
Well, I'm gonna end the video here, guys. So in the next video, I'll do part 3 of the Black Ops 3 campaign, so... See you guys in the next video. Bye.